Okay, hi Vlogmas. It is Christmas Eve, December 24th, which is Vlogmas day 20th for me. I'm super stressed out right now. It's 11:30 and I'm just so upset that I can't even talk. Husband started off the day, I got up to go pee. I was like, I have to pee. He's like, well, I want to talk to you. I was like, okay, well, I'm going to go pee, so talk to me through the bathroom door. And he just stood outside and he was just like, blah, blah, blah. I hope you don't think we're going to be getting gifts for the rest of the relatives. Blah, blah, blah. That's not on my list of priorities. Like, OMG. All for months, I've been telling him we needed to, you know, get the gifts. And he was like, okay, kind of. And we have, like, 4 gifts left that we weren't able to afford because the car had to go in the shop. And he gets paid today. And we were going to get them after he got paid.
Trouble.
And he had given me some money because I was going to go a little bit of cash because I was going to get our son a gift because all the kids are getting new stuffed animals except him, so I wanted to run to Walmart and see if I could find him something. And my husband was like, use that money to get all the relatives' gifts you want. And I was like, that's not enough. It's only like, you know, $15 or whatever. He's like, well, too bad. He's just being a jerk. It's just like so much drama and trouble. He just provokes and causes trouble for no reason. I was like, it's Christmas Eve, man. Why do you have to be such a jerk? But that's the only way he knows how to be. So, also to make matters infinitely worse, it is rainy and it is 70 degrees outside now. That might be cool for some people, but it's Christmas Eve in Northeast Pennsylvania and it should not be 70 degrees. I'm so disgusted. Everything is sticky and humid, and it's humid, so it makes my sinuses just like, because I have sinus issues. So yeah, needless to say, I'm really just stressed out today, so I'm sure it's going to be horrible, and yeah.
Baby!
Hi, baby!
Mommy!
You got little feet!
My baby!
Spider-Man!
Baby!
Spidey!
Dad!
Playing with these little trains. Choo choo!
Choo choo!
Thomas?
See.
And this one is playing with his little tracks.
Mommy!
What are you doing?
Santa!
And we're watching Mickey Mouse thing. And they push along. They're pretty cool if it worked correctly. Why is my camera not holding still? They're pretty cool.
Keep stopping on the track that I keep pushing. Now, this is the best part.
But for some reason, that track, the orange one always gets stuck. And then the blue one gets stuck there, and it waits for the orange one. And then they go together like friends again. Woohoo! Yeah. Alright, friend. Nope, Dominic, don't kick it.
When it comes over again, I'm gonna go look at the...
That's what you guys are playing with. Yay, Christmas! Say hi, Vlogmas!
Hi, Vlogmas!
Hi, Vlogmas!
This is the church, St. John the Evangelist. Super pretty. Even if it is red brick. Okay, so this is just to show you the temperature on Christmas Eve. Even though I've been raving about it. already. Okay, I don't know if this can pick up the sky, kind of. It doesn't pick it up as well on the camera, but it's like pinkish and blue and stripes. And it actually looks really cool. That's the church where I just went to service. St. John's, their mom's list. Nope. Holy crap, what is going on? Okay, so I wanted to, oh! Wow, that totally works so much better. Okay, wow, now I'm in the car. I just wanted to make this video real quick before it gets dark. Oh, I was just gonna grab something in my purse, but no, the camera's on it. It's December 24th. And I'm like 2 seconds away from crying, not because I'm super emotional, but because it was awesome. I went to the Christmas Eve service with my cool hat, even though it's 65 degrees. But I went to the Christmas Eve service at St. John's Evangelist, and it's a Lutheran church, and I've never really attended a Lutheran service, so I don't think. Hey, there's somebody else going to the church with a Christmas hat on! Oh, that's awesome! They're gonna have another service at like 7, it's 4:40 now, but anyway, and it was totally, like, I didn't know what to expect. I was just looking, you know, for a service that was traditional, and it's like if traditional church was not Catholic. We sang all songs, you know, that I knew and everything, but it was sermon, and the people were super friendly, and the cool thing is it actually seems like there are, now it's crooked, okay, now I'm like leaning. It seems like there are a varied age of people there. A lot of older women and men. But then there are a whole bunch of younger people. And the service is 10:45 and 8 o'clock in the morning and stuff. So it sucks for me, once again. You know, I can't attend any Sunday services because Peter monopolizes the car. And Sunday, because it's apparently his day. Which sucks. But I would totally attend here again. And there's somebody walking down the street with the Great Pyrenees. Holy crap, that dog is gorgeous. Should I totally film it? No, that'd be weird, filming people and their dog. Anyway, and it, like, I haven't been in a good church service in so long. And which is kindness and not, like, over-exuberantly kind people like, hey, welcome to our service. You know, we're fake. It was just cool, and it was just, like, blessed. And you could tell, and the church is beautiful. And I took some video, but they were kind of shutting everything down, so I didn't take too much. But, I would probably totally go there if I had, you know, didn't live with a dictator or whatever. So, so close. It was, like, really uplifting, and I could never attend because of him. Anyway, Merry Christmas. Okay, bye. So I just got in the door, and as you can probably hear in the background, there are two babies sitting at the table screaming. And my husband was just throwing a fit about, he was like sending me text messages and telling me on the phone, I'm not in that car by 6:01. You will never set foot in this vehicle again. I'm serious. Your final warning. He sends like all these threats and stuff, and I'm like, okay, I don't care. But anyway, I want to tell you this. This was really funny and was just one of those moments outside of this house that makes my life happy. You know, most of the moments that make my life happy are outside of this house. But, so I was in the Dollar Tree, and every year, this happened last year too, there is a guy who he has this ridiculous Santa suit, and it's not just a red and white, it's more like, the, like, dark, almost maroon brocade, and he actually had it specially made. It's a real, like, suit, and it's covered with, like, jingle bells and all kinds of things, and he has candy canes, and he has this whole setup, and he grows his beard out, and every year, I guess the thing is, he walks around, there's, like, this plaza of stores, it's, like, the movie theater, and the Chinese, and the restaurants, and then, you know, there's a Dollar Tree, and a Hallmark, and a chocolate store, and a shoe store, and all the way down to Kmart. It's, like, a huge stretch. And I guess he just walks in and out of the stores, and he just Merry Christmases everybody and makes people smile and hands out candy canes. And he came into the Dollar Tree, so I was in the Dollar Tree, and I just kept hearing these jingle bells all throughout the store while I was shopping. And I was just singing, you know, na 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 na. I was like, oh, I gotta find out where those jingle bells are coming from. And then he walked by, But I literally, like, had somebody been filming me, it would have looked like I was just a little kid. I was like, oh, Santa! And I was all excited. And so I ran up and he gave me a candy cane. He was like, Merry Christmas. I was like, oh, yay. And then he kept walking and I was thinking, oh my goodness, that's the same Santa that was here last year. He's awesome. I should get a picture with him. And of course I was shopping, so I had stuff in my cart. So then I hear him jingling, and I was kind of like sneaking up on him because I was like, I'm going to be a stalker. And then I heard him say, Merry Christmas, everybody. Goodbye. And walk out. And I was like, no. And I was like, oh, super depressed. I was like, my life sucks again. And this is what happened last year, because last year I saw him and I was like, I got to get a picture. And then I didn't. But anyway, so then he walked out. So I finished my shopping. I leave. And I'm getting my key out, and then I hear the jingle bells. I was like, where is he? And there was actually a security guard standing there outside, because they have security that, like, is there and keeps an eye on the plaza at night now. And I must have just seemed like a crazy person, and I was like, where are the bells coming from? Where is Santa? All of a sudden I look, and he's all the way down at the, all the way down at the other end of the plaza by the Kmart, and he was just exiting. And there was a woman and a man and kids, and they were all, like, getting pictures and stuff. And this woman and guy, like, a couple, a younger couple, and they were, like, the last ones. And I guess she had been holding phones for people, and they got a picture, and they were just walking back. So I'm, like, you know, waddling my fat self down there. I'm like, oh, my goodness, I gotta catch him. And as I, like, am getting down, it's a million fars, and I'm fat. And the couple's coming this way, and he's just, like, heading out towards his sleigh. And I was just like, wait, Santa! And I was like, and the girl was like, oh, Santa, somebody needs to see you or something. And I was like, oh my goodness, I feel like a loser. And so I said, I gotta get a picture with you or I'm gonna feel like a total idiot. And the girl was like, right? So they kept walking. And then I looked around and I realized there was no one to take the picture. So I stopped her and I was like, could you take the picture? And Santa was like, that's what she's just did for everyone else. And I was like, oh, sorry. Anyway, long story, ridiculously, slightly less longer. So she took two pictures, and of course when other people take pictures, you know, you have no control over how totally fat you look. I probably should have just taken like a selfie, but then you wouldn't have seen his whole suit. So it's really cool pictures. She took two of them, and they're really cool, but I just look like a whale. I wish I could like Photoshop myself out of them. Maybe I will. But the Santa suit is great, and I'm gonna see if I can get it on the camera from my phone and show you guys, because it's awesome. I should have filmed them, actually, but I didn't even think. But, okay, hold on a second. Oh my goodness, I totally look like a whale. Just don't look at me. But I had my Santa hat on. We'll just block me out. But, like, you can't really tell in here, because it's all out of focus and stuff. This is one of the pictures. And he has, like, authentic boots, and the lady in the dollar store is actually talking to another customer, talking about how this guy does this every year, and he had a suit specially made, and it's, like, you can't see it on here, but it's got, like, gold, and it's, like, official, and it's really awesome, and the boots are great, and the belt, and he has ice packs, actually, underneath it to keep himself cool, and, there were two pictures, and back out. Oh, I can't get it close without it being all out of focus. Well, there it kind of is. But this guy's great. And he was just like, I'm Santa. And I was like, duh. And he has a capelet. See the capelet over the top? Like, that's this thing up here. A capelet, it's called, or whatever. But, and he's got the white and the black. And he actually looks a lot more like St. Nicholas than you would expect. But, yeah. So, I'm fat. But, so that's more of a better picture right there. But it was so much fun! It was so much fun, and I, like, tracked him down. I was so excited. I was just excited to see Santa. Because sometimes you just need to see Santa Claus in your life, darn it. Ugh. So anyway, happy Christmas Eve. It was just... yeah. And now I've got that fiasco of a Christmas tree to deal with, and I don't even know if I have the energy tonight to decorate it. I don't know. I don't know what's going to happen. My husband will probably throw a fit and be like, oh, I'm going to decorate it. And it'll just look like shit. Because he has no concept of where to put things or how to make it look even or pretty or... Anyway, I don't know. We'll see. But anyway, it was super fun and I'm glad I got to go to the church service and I'm glad I got to see Santa. And yeah.